We're at this Buddhist type temple here on Liverpool Road in Sydney. You have the Chinese zodiac around here and these various levels going up here. All over the building you have the little, what we know as commonly know as the little swastika design. And you have the etheric, all sorts of etheric aspects to it. You have the lion's paws. You can see them featured here with the face coming out through, like, through the ether, if you will, kind of merging face. You can see this again with the face kind of coming out of the ether. And the offerings right here for the temple. You have the pillars with the etheric creatures kind of going up and down the pillars in a way. And within the paw there, the kind of etheric orb also, the pearl in the mouth of the dragon, although really possibly an etheric orb actually coming out of the mouth of the dragon. With the foliage, you can see it up here. It's sort of spurting out from one point, then spurting through and then spurting out again. Now going up. Just to point out with the entranceway here that we have, yes, the red doors and the 1, 2, 3 sort of entryways to the center right here, as you will see in many other places, particularly covered by Richard Cassaro, but the 1, 2 right here, 3 right there. So we're going in, and you have this wheel right here, and the emanation from the wheel, which I would suspect would be a representation of a certain status of a chakra. And we can go upstairs and have a look. Within this temple here, so this figure here, for example, just looking at it with just the aura up here with the fire around, definitely the fire dimension represented there. And interestingly, out of the armor, you see the face coming out there, and there are other representations within the temple here. As a comparative between Asia and Egypt, it's unmistakable with the furniture and the lion's paws. Now you can see on here the foliage also. Even within the Masonic Center here in Sydney, you can see the lion's paws emanating out of the foliage. So it's a cross-continental comparison there. Within this temple, you have the what would be monks lined up here, three at a time, and in each setting. And just a bit of a look through, really. I'll try not to trip over things. Various expressions. So I'll try and deal with the light here. We have this huge, all these little figurines on here. So just having a quick look through here. And just to note a few things, here again is that the fire represented with the aura around here, and then within there you have the dragons represented as well around the mage in this case. And indeed in this one we can see the queen, and then around the queen within that kind of auric field you can see an entity within there also. But looking further within here, Buddha with the small figures right here, the children, which in a way may also be, in fact, the cherubim around the mage in this case. Here is the classic Mary with the sun, etc. The goddess with the child symbology, and on the lotus, this is in the astral. In this case, you have, in a way, you kind of have the orb in one hand and you have the staff in another, with this Buddha type character here, again, up through the chakras and on the lotus. And you can tell by the symbology of the lotus that these figures are up through the chakras. This here from the hand, you have the foliage emanating from the hand. The hand is one of the portals of the body from whence you get, say, from the base chakra, you would get the cornucopia emanating out and so forth. So we'll just go up, we'll have a quick look around the back here. There, you actually have the three steps. It's rather dark, but you can have the three steps coming up around here. And then just with the figurines, you have the crown chakra represented up here within the aura. You have the dragon symbology. You also have the foliage symbology. And within the temple here, you have the sort of foliage and creatures, with the creatures also, but it's an emanation from the foliage, as you can see in various depictions. So coming through here further, again, the aura, and in this case, the etheric swirls, and I show these etheric swirls here, there, and everywhere, particularly on the architecture. Again, in this case, with the children, this may well be the cherubim around the mage in that case. The hand signal, as you will see, the same sort of hand signals, which I think are within alchemy, the direction of various currents for various statuses. The crown chakra represented there by the hair, the third eye chakra right there, the ajna chakra, and the crown chakra represented in the background there. Interesting with this symbology here, and if we look, you can see an offering there of the coins in the hands, but also in that kind of groin area, which is interesting. It's rather phallic in a way, this representation right here, and in a way it's almost a bit of a reminder of the cornucopia emanating from that groin area, emanating from the base chakra region. The fire well represented around here, the auric field, this dimension around the mage. As it happens, just within the temple here, round windows of the Chinese right there, those sort of portal ways, but we have just a bit of a thing here with meta energy, and that extra energy, that light around the human form right there. So just back over this way just for a moment. One thing to notice here with the foliage is that you have the little ring here, and you see that on the fleur-de-lis, for example. And another thing to notice in here with the fire right here, that this figure, among other aspects, has the sword right here, and the sword has all these kind of markings on it, as if it's an etheric magnetized sword that can wield energies, strangely enough. The bell symbology, and also with this creature here, you will notice that you have, if you've got the central column right there, you've got the two creatures emanating from the center, as if emanating from the what would be, and you can see that there's sort of a lotus there, so emanating out of that chakra tree, if you will. And strangely enough, if you look at this depiction, you can see these creatures kind of emanating from the person, from the chakras. In this case, you have the anthropomorphized dragon at the stomach right there, interestingly, with all the ether around it, an etheric creature. Holding the sacred geometry, the architecture on the hand there, and you will see this within other depictions also, with priests holding architecture and so forth. Here you have the dragons, which are elemental creatures, at the shoulders there. In a way, you have the 1, 2, and 3, so in a way they kind of assist the mage in the center right there. And here you can see them up here with the heart chakra, burning heart chakra, right in the center, just as you will see with within the likes of Christianity and so forth. Interesting here that just even with the circles kind of going up here, in this case, the lucky number of 8 in Chinese culture with the orbs. Not sure what the writing is within there. Just along, going along this way, just to make a note of the 3 right here. And in a way, there's kind of 3 parts with the 3 priests meeting of fire and water, yin yang, male, female in the center, the hand signal, as you will see within Western culture, the hand signal also, and just a bit of a comparison. So, nice little temple, and there's another one of the heart, burning heart, heart chakra, coming through, and then through here, just a little bit more. Another case of here, with the entities coming out of the human and the participant, the chair also, with the lion's paws type thing, the sacred geometry in the hand, offerings right here, hand signals, a higher status there, it's a bit hard to see. Through here, further imagery, the notable shape shifting right here of the entity, and you will see this within occultism. You would have and I actually think that these shape shifts, crazily enough, happen, and you can see this kind of represented easily within Freemasonry. Also in the back room here, you have, this is a place where like a little crematorium, if you will, well, where the remains are in this particular part, with all the offerings right here for the ashes of the dead in here.